Starz TV. Hi, this is the King of Trainers. Today we're going to be talking about the Huarache game, aka the Huarache hype, aka what's happening to Huaraches now. Okay, so with Huaraches, I think the main thing we have to point out is Huaraches are being re-released now. The main Huaraches came out in like 2001. That was Tinker Hatfield's, one of Tinker Hatfield's first designs when it came to a running shoe. It was like a neoprene running shoe that he wanted to sort of target the running market in. So fast forward to now, it's Huarache, the Huarache hype is crazy because all the Huaraches that came out back in the 90s and when they sort of brought them right back out in I think 2000 and some, is that now it's the hype has gone ballistic. I mean, Huaraches came out at a price point of around £64 back in the 90s, and now they have risen to about £94. What's happened is, people have to understand, what's happened is, in the trainer game now, everyone wants to go back to the originals of what Tinker Hatfield designed. That's my opinion. That's why the Air Max 1s have been so popular, and the Huaraches, the Air Max 1 is 87, and Huaraches is 91. So what's happening now is everyone's going back to the fact that I want to go back to the era of when the whole thing started. So Nike have seen that and been like, okay, so you guys want Huaraches now. So they're re-releasing Huaraches. They've done a exclusive deal with Foot Locker for the black Huaraches, which were, I think, the fastest selling Huaraches ever. I'm not sure. Please, you know, put your comments below. If I get it wrong, just let me know. You know, the king, I don't mind criticism. But, and they restocked, I think, 3 times, and they sold out every single time. And that was a colorway. That was a colorway from, I think, 2006. You know what? I can't remember. But either way, this is the Huarache hype. But what's happening now is the Huarache price point has changed because so many people love Huaraches. It's funny because, in my opinion, Huaraches are sort of, they're sort of at this tilting point where it's gone up, but it could be coming down. But at the same time, in the time it's coming down, more Huaraches are getting released. It feels like every week there's like a new Huarache. I mean, you've got the new white colorway with the blue speckle that's like in Foot Locker. You've got the size exclusive, the navy pack, the army. So you've got so many new colorways coming out. The price point has increased, I feel, from a business perspective. Because if you sort of look at it, in 20 years, from £64.99, only about £30 to £94.99 isn't really a big jump. Like, that's what people have to understand. In terms of inflation and stuff, it should actually be double, you know, according to other things. But it's not really a big jump. But the reason why it's so expensive, maybe like the ones at Foot Locker are £94.99, because most of them are Foot Locker exclusives. So Foot Locker are obviously gonna add their extra profit on top of it, etc. But you have like other shops like Offspring that sell it for £79.99, the size that sell it for £79.99, etc. etc. But my take on the Huarache hype is, I believe people love Huarache so much because it was that shoe back in the day that was the cool shoe. Without the air bubble, it was that cool shoe. It was so comfortable and it was cool. And the people who saw it back in those days may have seen it on their older brothers or their older cousins or siblings or people at school, but I'm not saying couldn't afford it, but it wasn't their time. You know, every trainer, you can't have, you know, unless you got money from where you're little, you can't have trainers that you want all the time. So now that it's the people are working and they can afford to buy these Huaraches, it's become like, I need to get the Huaraches. Personally, I think Nike is sort of exploiting the game. That's my personal opinion. You know, Nike, don't sue me. I'm just saying, it's my opinion, the king's opinion, is that with the Huaraches now, it's become how many colors we can release, you know, and the quality is dying. Like, the Huarache quality is like, it's dying. Like, I don't even like understand it. Like, I mean, you could have like maybe a scream green Huarache from like old, like 1991, and you compare it to maybe a release now, and it's like the glue's like all around the sides, like the, you know, the straps, like the threads coming out, etc., etc. So I feel that like Nike as a company should be like, you know what, we understand about our money and our markup and our profit, but we still have to go back to our ethos, which was producing a great running shoe. Remember, the Huarache is a running shoe. The Huarache is not a fashion shoe. People don't get it twisted now. It is a running shoe. You know, it was at a time when running and marathons were the hit in the 90s. People started to get fit. The fitness age came in the 90s. The gyms were emerging all over the place. And Huarache came out. So it came out for a fitness purpose. But now, you can't even wear the Huaraches to run. You running a Huarache, that stuff is breaking apart. So we got to get back to that whole thing. And maybe we need to do things like, you know, write, not petitions. No one's going to boycott Huaraches. That's the truth. Like, they could not release anything they want and people are still going to buy it. But we need to sort of approach Nike in a way where there needs to be some sort of quality control and be like, yo, these trainers are not as good quality as the last ones, you know? And see if they actually, you know, because I feel that Nike have it upon themselves to do great trainers. Like, they're the biggest training company in the world. They make loads of money. There's no reason for bringing out a poor quality shoe. And I feel that now with these Huaraches, they've done that. They just bring out so many different Huaraches. It's crazy. Some of the collabs are amazing. Like, the Size collab, shout out to the guys at Size. The collabs that they do, the quality is a lot better. I feel the Army Navy pack they've just released, I saw that, I held it, I tried it on, the quality was amazing. And I feel that, you know, there's certain trainers that they release and they can have a great quality. But with Huaraches, it's just, I don't know. But is the Huarache hype dying? I guess that's an opinion for you guys. Let me know. Hit us up on the comments below and tell us if the Huarache hype's dying. Are you going to be going out for the new Huaraches? In my opinion, I think the Huarache hype is on a plateau where it's either going to go higher or dip or just stay the same, you know? So that's been the Huarache hype. My name's been the King of Trainers. You're watching Soul Street in conjunction with Street Starz TV. I hope you enjoyed it and we'll see you next time.